first time I've left my little boy.
So, you're leaving your son and I'm returning to mine. I'm Countess Vronskaya. I've been in St. Petersburg for the christening of a granddaughter. My elder son married Princess Cherkov. You're a charming creature. Why don't I know you?
I've never been in Moscow society, really.
But you know my name.
I've heard you mentioned.
Talked about, you mean? Ah, love.
Was it love?
Always. My sons are ashamed of me, but I'd rather end up wishing I hadn't than end up wishing I had, wouldn't you?
I don't know.
Oh, I am. I really am.
Yes, of course. Oblonsky's sister, Karenina.
Charmant, don't you think?
Countess, you have found your son and I have found my brother.
Madame Karenin has a son too. It's the first time they've been apart, so she frets about him.
Excuse me for not recognizing you before.
Au revoir, Countess. Au revoir, my dear. Let me kiss that pretty face.
From a large family, they say.
Well, can't anything be done for them?
Wait for me, Mama. Stand back.
I have you to thank for that.
Oh. Oh, what a good fellow. What a good fellow.
Have you known Count Vronsky long?
Did you like him? He's in love with Kitty.
Who? But we should be discussing you and Dolly. What have you got to say for yourself?
I've said it all. On my knees, in tears. Now I need you to say it. I'm going to the office, so you'll have Dolly to yourself.
Don't be late home.
I be of service to you.
Why are you leaving Moscow?
What else can I do? I have to be where you are.
Stop, that's enough. Go back to Kitty. This is wrong.
It makes no difference.
You have no right.
It makes no difference.
You must forget me. If you're a good man, you'll forget everything.
And you? Will you forget?
Yes.
Princess Betsy?
Cousin, I didn't know you were an art lover.
I'm prepared to be one. Is it all right? Sit down a minute.
I want to see everything.
A moment.
And now I'm doing kitchen maid's work, because Nadia's parents won't let us set foot in the house. And who can blame them? It's indecent.
It's Constantine.
Yes, good. A doctor here is useless. Get me one from Moscow.
Where did you go? I asked for you everywhere when I was getting married.
I'm sorry. I couldn't leave him.
Yes. My wife. You can't stay now.
I will nurse him with a gaffier. The woman will find somewhere in the village. You won't see her. She knows it is impossible to meet you. It is a torment to me that I've brought you under the same roof as this unfortunate, as this fallen, and in your precious, in your delicate condition.
What cost you? Good. A clean night shirt and sheets. A towel and a clean pail of warm water. Wait. And bring the perfume bottle. In the outside pocket of my handbag.
I'm here to see Seriosha.
Madame? I beg your pardon, Your Excellency.
No, I've come to see Seriosha.
You must love Papa. He's better than I am.
No one in the whole world is better than you.
Thank you. Where's Anya?
She's still asleep. Should I take your coat? Are you feeling unwell, madam?
I'm not sleeping.
I can send out for something.
Yes.
Why are you in the dark? The Ashvin's going to call. You remember him. Are you going out?
To where? To whom?
What's the matter?
I didn't know what happened to you.
But I told you yesterday, my brother.
But does it take all day to meet your brother? Does he need you more than I do?
What's happened? Well, Alexander agreed to everything. Mother's house in Moscow will go to him, and the country estate will be our new home. As soon as they divorce, Karenin hasn't answered your letter yet.